PLC doesn't actually read the function keys. Instead, the CMOR micro writes the key status to a tag down on the PLC, and then the PLC can read that tag and take the appropriate action. Each key is mapped to a bit in one of these two words here. So for example, if I hold down the F5 key, we can see that bit 4 at this 100 address, watch this guy right here, hold down F5, so bit 4, which is a decimal 16, corresponds to function key F5. And F1, for example, he's bit 1 at that tag. Let's see how to set that up. You can reach that from the Navigation Windows Function tab, PLC to Panel, or under the Setup menu, PLC to Panel. Under the Panel to PLC tab, we just enter the PLC tag where we want the panel to send the current screen number. Not the function keys, the screen number. We're using the screen number tag, which is located at address DS100 on a click PLC. Then the CMOR micro will use the next two addresses, 100 plus 1 and 100 plus 2 in this example, to store the key information, if we enable it by checking this checkbox. Each bit in these two words shows the status of a single key, an arrow key, a function key, a numeric digit on the bezel, etc. The mapping of those keys is shown in this little chart right here. So F1 would be bit 1 in the address plus 1. The decimal key would be this 15th bit in address plus 2. Let's try and see how it works. So we'll bring up the simulator, save the project. So now, anytime a key is pressed, we should see that result in these two words. So let's see, F1 was that first bit at the offset of 1, and there it is. I'm looking at this tag right here. And then when I let go, that status goes away. Let's see, we said that the decimal point was the 15th bit of that second word. And sure enough, we can see that in this tag over here. So each key is mapped to a single bit in one of these two words. There's a whole video showing you how to read screen numbers from the PLC, so check that out if you want to learn more about that. Well, that's all there is to reading the function key status. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.